Welcome to another video lecture. Today we will work down a problem related with the analysis of cable with the NZ2 different levels. Okay, I hope all of you have watched the previous section related with the theory part. So write down the question. A cable of span 100 meter has its end at the heights 8 meter and 15 meter above the lowest point of the cable. It carries a uniformly distributed load of 10 kN per meter per unit horizontal run of the span. Determine the horizontal and vertical reaction at the support. What is the length of the cable? I hope all of you have write down the question. So then please listen carefully. This is very simple if you know the formula directly. If you know the formula, then you can calculate the horizontal and vertical reaction length of the cable very easily. So let us see the question. So a cable is given, the point A is here and B point is here, let us assume. And the height difference from the lowest point is given as 8 meter and the second point is 15 meter. And the distance between these two supports or two points A and B is 100 meter given. So H1 is 8 and H2 is 15 meter. And here VA vertical and here horizontal component. And VB at this point B. Okay. So the UDL also given 10 kN per meter. So if you know the formula directly, you can calculate the value very easily. So we know that the formula is L1 equals L into square root of H1 by square root of H1 plus square root of H2. This is the formula to calculate the distance from this point A to point C. Okay, this is very directly you can apply L1. If you know L1, then L2 will be also you can calculate by L minus L1. L2 equals L minus L1. So this is a formula you can directly apply. And also you can able to find out the horizontal thrust also. W is given here, L 100 already given, and H1 and H2 also you know, and the total length also you can determine very easily if you know the formula. And now I am going to explain, if you forgot those formula, how to determine. So we are going to analyze by taking moment about this point A and also point B from the middle or the lowest portion. Only we are going to consider this part and this part only. Separately we are going to consider. So here the horizontal component will be here and the vertical component will be 0 here. Okay. So H into 8. 8 means you are going to take the moment about to point A. First case, taking moment about to the point A. So H multiplied by 8 minus 10. You are only considering this much portion. So 10 into L1, that is another force, into L1 by 2. Okay, equals 0. So it is going to happen 8H equals 5 L1 square. 8H equals 5 L1 square. Similarly, find out from this right side also, you will get this value. This 8 into H is in the clockwise direction. And this direction how? It is going to happen. It is in the anti-clockwise direction. So the value is going to 8H equals 5 L1 square. Okay. Then here we can see that equation. This is 1 and this is 2. So 1 by 2 gives L1 square by L2 square equals 8 by 15. So finally, you will get this is the value. L1 by L2 equals 0.7. 0 by 1. Then you are going to apply dividend or commutator rule. So L1 by L1 plus L2 equals 0.7301 plus 0.730. So finally, you will get L1 value 42.214 and L2 value is 57.786. So this is the step if you forgot those values, this direct equation. Okay, only then you go to apply these formulas. Otherwise, you can easily find out these values. So don't waste the time if you bypass this formula. Then coming to this vertical reaction, we know that if you are going to consider this part only, this VA and WL1 is only acting. So sigma V equals 0, then VA equals this force only. So VA equals W into L1, we know that W and also L1, so finally the value is got. And VB also, we are going to consider only this small portion. And finally, W into L2, and you got the value. And regarding horizontal thrust, you can directly apply here or here. And you will get the value. This is the value. And total length equation, directly apply. L plus 2 by 3 into H1 square by L1 plus 2 by 3 into H2 square by L2. So finally, you will get the value. So this section is very easy if you buy out the formulas. So regarding with this different points also, different levels also, if UDL is acting, you can easily find out. And if the case of analysis of cables, when the two supports are at the same level also, you can apply the formulas. And regarding some other problems related with you, sometimes it may ask to find out the tension in the cable. Okay, that also you can write down as square root of V square plus H square. Already we find out in the previous sections. So I hope all of you are following this section also. With this, we will wind up today's section. Thank you.